as we've developed this education, and I've been part of the education, we've really grown a lot, you know, in 25 years for the Shingo Prize. And this gives us an opportunity to talk about kind of the next evolution of the education offered by the Shingo Prize, which is our executive education. And so I just want to take a few minutes and talk briefly about that, and then have, if there's any questions that you guys have over the education or the executive education and what it entails, we'll provide time for that. But this is really just to give kind of an overview of what this coursework looks like, and some who this is for, who should be taking this, what they get out of it, and so forth. So kind of to start, I want to show just kind of where the Shingo Prize has come from and what our teaching philosophy is. As we've taught for the last 25 years, we've taught predominantly one single course, which is kind of what we call that Discover course, the Principles of Operational Excellence. In fact, many of you that are probably online have been through that course. It's a two-day, we require from all examiners, and it's kind of a fundamental course on principles of operational excellence and how to see those through a different lens. That's what we call our Discover course. And after people have gone through that, you know, a common question that a lot of people have had is, so what's next? You know, after we discover principles and systems and tools and how they come together, or what we call that architecture, that framework, they want to know how to mobilize. How do you use that understanding? And we have now, just in this year, in 2012, we came out with another course called How to Build Systems to Drive the Right Behavior. So this is kind of our build course. And we teach this as an individual, kind of a la carte type workshop, where people can now look at systems and how they drive behavior and how to adjust those systems to drive a behavior. Well, along with that, after you start building that, you need to also assess and align the direction of your organization. So there's that check element. And then finally, you know, how we lead as leaders. Now, all of these are what we call the four disciplines of operational excellence: the discover, build, lead, and align. And we've always taught these, or we've taught them as individual workshops. So you can come to one and understand all the discover. You can come to another and understand how to build. For leaders, you know, we taught this last conference, the lead course. So how do you lead as a continuous improvement or transformational leader in your organization? And then finally, how do you assess? Well, what we've done with executive education is pulled all four disciplines together to create a seamless learning experience for individuals. So now when they go, you know, what do I do now after operational excellence, after I've taken your two-day workshop, what can I do with principles? We've put something together that starts knitting all these key learnings together, and not just knits them together, but it brings a support group with them through a year-long what we call an executive certificate program, where they can discover and learn as a group. And really what they're doing is taking a theoretical knowledge and bringing in a practical application to it, their own practical application. So we attend, you know, we go to these eye-to-eye or these workshops where we meet together personally, and then we step away from that for a period of time and do some homework, do some assignments, connect in our own organization, and bring those back together once again to this group to go to the next phase. All of this really trying to help organizations run through a transformational process. And transforming an organization from a tool-based to a principle-based organization. And that's one of the key learning objectives that we're looking at here. So I want to talk just some of the key components that we have. If you notice on top, obviously we're in this year-long certificate program, we're meeting together as groups four times. These would be those workshops. Now, as we meet, we're going to be picture what the Shingo Prize has done in the past. In the last 3 years, we've done study tours. So we go out to Shingo Prize recipients and we go observe and go see. This is kind of a hybrid or combination of both a study tour and those workshops, and a learning component that brings it back to your gemba, your site. So the first one, if you notice, as we go out, the first meeting is always the discover. That's a two-day workshop. Here we do it for 3 days, and we go to a Shingo Prize recipient. So when we first start out, and all these start in Salt Lake, we go to 2 Shingo Prize recipients so they can learn and see what does it really look like? What does a principle-driven organization look like, feel like, taste like? And so at this point, you know, we can go into organizations and talk to associates, talk to managers, and probably most importantly, talk to leaders and how they lead these kind of organizations. So that first one, we see a Shingo Prize recipient. And after that, we have these others. So when we come together as a group, and these groups are about, we're looking at about 16 to 18 people per group, and I'll talk more about the individuals a little bit later, but we're talking about a cohort of about 16 to 18 individuals. Now, as we meet, you know, that first Shingo Prize recipient, and I'll talk more logistics in just a bit, the next one is the build. Here is where we actually go to some of the participants' host sites. So for those that that are in the cohort, if they want the group to come to their site, sign up quick because those usually go up pretty fast. But this is where we'll go to their actual site of one of the cohort members, and we do the workshop, the Gemba, the go-see, you know, everything there on site. So each one of these is paired to a specific a site, facility, or organization. So when we go to the build, we will go to one of the facilities plants, and we get to see systems there, and we work on, so how would you build a system to drive the right kind of behavior? The next one, when you look at the lead, we go back to a Shingo Prize recipient. Again, this is a key one. We want to show, so what does it mean to truly lead a principle-driven organization? And so we take you to these Shingo Prize recipients that, and these are in North America, but to talk to these leaders and how they embed principles into the organization, how they get associates to embrace these principles. And the last one is the align. So we go back to a participant host facility to help understand and see alignment. So in each one of these four, we are at a Gemba. We're at a site. To see actual experience, actual, you know, see reality. In between these, and I'm not going to go so much in the detail of the coursework for each one. So for architecture or principles of operational excellence, if you want to go to the website, you can see some of the key learning objectives. In fact, if you drop down, you can see them, you know, below, describe the benefits of focus on principles, articulate principle-driven behavior. These are some of the objectives of that course. One of the key pieces that we are leveraging the certificate program with is taking this group and creating smaller groups, so when they leave the Discover, they will work, they'll give a homework assignments to go see, go assess your organization, do a behavioral assessment, see where you fall, and then we'll have team webinars. We'll break you up into smaller teams of about 4 to 5. These teams will then be that working group that will support, complete homework, and then we also have a call where we just confirm, kind of touch base, hold everyone accountable for the assignments that you'll be doing in between. So what this allows us to do is really take the theoretical, the workshop, be able to go see it, what it looks like, and then go practice this in your own organization. And then do some report backs to your team and when you come back to the main group for the next workshop. So you're slowly building this learning and observation journal as you move through. Now, by the time we hit build, we're going to start strategically constructing a system map and start looking at what are some key systems in your own organization that you can impact to drive this transformation and impact this transformation. As you go through, come to the lead, we'll be creating, you know, these critical action plans. So by the time you hit the align, you'll have a pretty complete roadmap and a starting point of where you've been now for this last year to really create traction. Now keep in mind, for the Shingo Prize, for those who challenge for the prize, we expect 3 years of results in organizations. 3 years of ideal behavior. What this really allows you to do is start taking that 1 year step and putting you in the right direction, helping you get ducks in a line so as you start moving down the informational process, you can you're not making as many mistakes as you would just by trial and error. You're really learning from this group. Now, what this would really take time-wise and time commitment, if we look at this, this is really what we're expecting for a time commitment from the participants. So each one of those workshops, they're about 2.5 days. We say 3 days because on the last day, we kind of end on a half day so you can still fly out and be home on the next day. So we really wanted to keep that to about 2.5 days. But that workshop, that face-to-face, is about 3 days. Count on about a day and a half, or about a day and a half to 2 days of, or about, you know, 8 to 16 hours of actual homework assignments, being on a webinar with your team, on calls with us, doing some of these assignments to complete, to get you ready for the next learning objectives for the workshop. So we expect about 8 to 16 hours here. Total gives you, you know, about 18 days of commitment for doing this. And, you know, we can argue that's a lot or a little. We really are trying to make this convenient or easy for a cohort to go through. So what we try to do as we schedule these times and slots, we put a hard date on the first one, on the Discover. So when everyone comes together, you'll see a hard date when we start that cohort. From that, we try to have a workshop per quarter. Not try, actually, we will have a workshop per quarter throughout the year. In between those quarters is where we have the homework and the assignments. At that first meeting with the teams, I encourage everyone to bring your calendar because we schedule out the next three face-to-face with that team. So we want to have everyone there on these as you go through. You really want to hold to that team. Now, as we go through, you know, there's an application process to this, and here's a website. You go to the shingleprize.org. You can see us on, you click on the education tab, and then it'll drop down. You'll see an executive education. There's the view brochure, which I just showed you, but also the apply now, which will print off the screen to the right, which you'll fill in, and there's the application. Now, what we're going to be doing in the future, we're going to have three types of cohorts that go through this. And there's pros and cons to all of these, but this application kind of helps us guide you in a cohort specifically, or if there's one that you just said this is the date that we need to go through, that's great. But the application also helps us as we go in the future. We would like to have three different types of cohorts. One, where it's open to all industry. And there's a lot of value to this because you can get multiple industry in there. You know, I just came off a study tour from Japan, and we had six different industries represented, you know, from healthcare to oil and gas to manufacturing, automotive, aerospace, and so forth. So with those kind of cohorts, an open one really provides a rich context, you know, of how to apply these in multiple industries. That's how we're starting these cohorts, is by a multiple industry a group. The second type is more industry specific. So we've had a lot of requests where, you know, for example, healthcare would like to have just all healthcare industry, or aerospace wants just all aerospace industry. Therefore, you know, they can you know, talk and communicate and, you know, be able to share very similar environments within each other. There's pros and cons with that one as well. The last one are for companies that want to hold this internally, just for their organization. So it's just open to a specific, not just industry, but a organization. So if the Shingo Prize wants to send all of our executives there, we would send them in as a group there, or the Huntsman School of Business, we just send them there as a group. So those are the three types of cohorts that we're looking at. And again, these are for, you know, in the future, we'll look at the latter two. The first ones that we are sending off are multiple industry groups. some of the, you know, as I look at the ideal participant that would be a good match for this type of executive certificate program, these are management level. They are, you know, general managers from plant to divisional, VPs, senior VPs, executive directors. They have management positions, so those that are in a position to transform an organization, make key decisions. Now, ideally, what we'd like to see are organizations signing up by twos, one management and one continuous improvement. Because as you go through this, what you'll realize, you know, if you send the leader out or the, you know, the manager, they'll go through this and they will, you know, start looking at these components and these action items and these homework assignments, and they'll go, wow, that's really a continuous improvement guy. That's my director of continuous improvement that needs to be part of this or understand this vision as well. If you just send your continuous improvement individual, you know, they'll be having kind of a very similar conversation where, you know, it's, I wish my, you know, the leaders were here to really see what I'm trying to do. You know, for some of these you know, systems, I need management to understand the behavior we're going to be driving with them. So ideally, it'd be good to have, you know, both the management and continuous improvement individual there from a single entity or single organization. Obviously, you know, we've had several sign up there, just individual, and that's great. Know that even when you go back to your facility after, you know, and you'll gauge with those people as well. Some other things about the ideal participant to this: a extensive lean understanding is not required, but a basic one is. You really, you know, when we talk about lean, and I'm going to take out the word lean, you know, continuous improvement, Six Sigma, theory constraints, TQM, have a working knowledge of, you know, the continuous improvement methodology and systems is key. We're not going to be spending a lot of time, in fact, this is not designed to teach tools and how to go back and use tools like, you know, 5S and value stream mapping. What this is designed to do is to go back and see what tools you have and how they interconnect to drive the behavior. So you're going to be going in and adjusting some of your systems. We're not too concerned of, you know, if you have 5S or if you call it 6S or 5S plus 1. We're more concerned of how you're using those tools and how you leverage them and adjust them to drive a behavior, ideal behavior. So knowledge-wise is, you know, some, you need to have a basic understanding of continuous improvement. It also, you know, helps to, if you've taken principles of operational excellence already, that helps. And then we get some push where they, you know, we've had some of the individuals that have signed up and said, well, I've already taken that. Let me kind of go back real quick. So right here on the Discover, that's the principles of operational excellence. Many, you know, have already taken this, and when we come into this, you know, some have asked, well, do I need to retake that? And the answer is absolutely. We have actually changed a little bit of the workshop. In fact, we'll be teaching the 2013 version of it come up this October. So you'll see some new stuff in there. But probably one of the primary reasons you need to be there is to create that network. You know, you're going to be with this team throughout the year, and it's important that you connect and meet up with your teammates and people that you're going to be going through this transformation with. So we encourage everyone, if you've taken it in the past, that's great, but this is to really start connecting with your team. Now, here's some key information about the certificate program. Tuition, $15,000, that's per person. This covers books, all the workshops, all the facility site fees they charge. So this covers everything, pretty much everything except for travel. Now, to the no substituting, what this means is, as you sign up for this and you kind of get through, and you want to send someone else to kind of step in your place, it's not going to happen. We really need that same individual there the whole time. For the same reason, you need to take, you know, the OpEx. It's keeping that consistency and that network of that person. Now, if you can't make, you know, the designated times that they set up at the beginning, There are makeup workshops. We hold these workshops quarterly, so you can make them up within the quarter, but you have to make them up within that time frame to keep going with your group. So there is that makeup option. Again, this is not ideal, but it does allow some flexibility for some of these groups. It is eligible for a continuous education credit. So for those that need those continuous education requirements, this is executive education. It's offered through the Huntsman School of Business. This is a certificate program administered through Utah State University and the Shingo Prize. So there is those, in fact, 50 credits for that year's time. Here are some key start dates for those groups that are coming through. The first one, we're starting off on October 17th and 19th. This one is filling up. So if you're interested in that one, the first one that we're kicking off, we'll be starting here in Salt Lake. For those that want to know the first Gemba site that we'll be looking at, this will be at U.S. Synthetic. We'll be, for those who are familiar with them, they're a Shingo Prize recipient and phenomenal organization. We're going to start there.